Tell me, what planet am I on?
Galactic habitat readings detect the planet is Consoline. Mostly high temperatures of around 130 degrees Celsius and is inhabited by giant flesh-eating creatures.
I mean, that doesn't sound too bad.
Also, heat signatures read that constant meteor strikes occur thoroughly.
Meteors? I mean, did you just say meteors?
Hey guys, how's it going? It is My Different Username here, and today I finally get the chance to show you all my latest creation. It is one that I've actually waited to make for quite a while now, and well, let's just say that it truly is something out of this world. Or should I say out of this galaxy? Well, anyway, here we have Han Solo's DL-44 Heavy Blaster Pistol made out of Lego. So, the DL-44 is a blaster pistol created by the company Blastech Industries and has followed use throughout the Galactic Republic and even as far as the Age of the Empire. This pistol is known to be extremely accurate, have heavy firepower, but unfortunately is restricted due to the heating issues that occur after consistent use of the weapon. It's also been used by many smugglers and bounty hunters alike across the galaxy, but the most famous of them all happen to be Han Solo, of course. And that is the lore of the gun, at least, but the actual prop itself is a loosely modified Mauser C96 pistol, which I've actually made a video of in the past, and essentially based my model here off of that. So if you guys want to see what is basically the real-life version of Han's blaster, consider checking out that video later down. But since then, I've been able to add a few more modifications to my model, which we could take a look at right now. So let's go ahead and take off all these extra bits here to reveal more of the base gun itself. Now it's a little easier to see the C96, and so far there's not much added to it. It's been modded to have a shorter barrel, the magwell has even been swapped out for the rings in the front, the trigger guard has a more rounded loop to it, but the pistol grip has definitely made the best change out of all of them. It actually features the same style of grip as my older model, but is now set to a more appropriate angle than before, and the grip not only looks more accurate to the real Mauser pistol, but is also pretty sturdy as well. I also wanted to make this as authentic towards the C96 as I possibly could, so the charging handle works just like the real one, which also affects the hammer too. The only unfortunate thing about this is the fact that because of these rings on the front of the magwell, the weapon can't accept the stripper clip with bullets, so it basically can't be loaded. Besides that though, I love every single change that I've made to make this C96 all that more accurate to the original model, as well as improving the look for the DL-44. Meanwhile, we could take a look at other parts of the blaster, like this muzzle device right here. On the original prop, it's actually based off of the MG-81 machine gun's muzzle brake, and let me tell you, the cone at the end was the trickiest part to replicate out of all of this, but I made the best attempt that I could given the limitations of LEGO itself, and the final result is probably what I deem to be the best looking design that I could possibly find for my DL-44 as of right now. Another part to this build is the scope that sits along the right side of the gun. It's based off of the Hensoldt and Wetzler 3x scope, and it's not a scope that was originally designed for the Mauser pistol, but has found its way to become an essential part of Han's blaster when it came to creating the prop. And since the model has been cut down from the front, meaning no front post sight to go with the rear sights, it's definitely in need of some solution to acquiring targets. And when you aim down the scope, it actually features a small claw piece on the bottom to help somewhat resemble the same image that you would see when using the real scope itself. And as far as practicality goes, the scope is really well built and super sturdy, while also having the convenience of allowing the scope to be easily removable thanks to the simplistic mount design. Overall, this blaster is truly a remarkable sight to behold. Every little detail that was added to it was to help make it as accurate to the real A&H prop blaster used in A New Hope, and I just feel so honored to have finally gotten the chance to build it myself. And once I heard that the new Solo movie was coming out, I couldn't think of a better time to ever build this rather than right now. I've seen many people over the years make their own version of this model, and now I can finally add my model to the vast list of all the DL-44 builds all over the world. Anyway, with all that said, I believe it's time to finally dress up, go out, and finally see what this blaster can really do.
Bad feeling about this.
All right, men, load your weapons.
Stormtrooper! Stormtrooper!
You guys can't hit a big...
Ow! Oh!
So guys, if you want to see more Star Wars or movie-related weapons later in the future, you should definitely consider subscribing and even hitting that bell notification to see more. Also, I just wanted to put this out there because I figured people would be really interested in this, but I actually do have plans to sometime in the future put this exact model of the DL-44 up for sale or auction, but only after I take it to this year's Brick World, where I'll be featuring this as well as other builds to go along with it. Just an idea though, so it might change, but you guys should definitely let me know in the comments what you think. Anyways guys, like, favorite, and comment if you guys have enjoyed the video, and as always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.